Dear friends, what we are going to come here is today, Osho's Shiva Sutra 39. What does it say? Intone a sound. What do you mean by intone? Say a sound. Intone a sound means say a sound as Om. A-U-M means what? Om. Intone a sound. Make a sound. Om. Slowly, slowly. You say it out loudly, then you go in slowly. As sound enters soundfulness. So slowly you are telling it louder, then slowly you are going inside and saying the Om slowly, very slowly inside your heart. Nobody is hearing. As sound enters soundfulness, Om, 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 you are saying inside, going deeper and deeper and deeper inside. Till there is no sound at all, right? So you are disappearing with the sound. So intone a sound as Om slowly. So you do a sound Om slowly. See, my dear friends, Om has three sounds. What are the words? Letters A, U and M. See, these are the end words. A, U and M. All the sounds you make in the world, all the languages, the foundation and the end word is Om. Everything is derived from the word Om. Om doesn't have a meaning. Om doesn't have a meaning. All the words derives from Om. There is no word beyond the word Om. Om is the end word. Like a railway station you go, this is the last stop. After this, there is no other stop. So this Om sound is the end stop. Stop for all the sounds. No other sound, no other word is there which the sound Om, other than this. Every sound is derived from the word Om. There is a great philosopher, or you can call him saint, Gurdjieff. He has told law of three. What is law of three? The absolute. What do you mean by absolute, man? Existence. You know existence. What is existence? The space, the universe, the earth, sun, moon, star, we, everybody. It is called existence. He told law of three. What is law of three? That is absolute. Absolute means what? Some people say it is God. Absolute means which cannot be seen, absolute, total. It will become a relative once you say it is absolute, because we don't know what is known, it is unknown. Unknown is absolute. Whether whichever it is known is not absolute. So three things are there in the world. What? Seer. Seer means what? I am seeing. What is the next one? Seen. What I see. I am the seer. You are the seen. In between what? Knowledge, cognition, understanding, what you are. So three things are there: seer, seen and understanding. Only these three things are there. One of the great philosopher, Lao Tzu, what he has said is, truth cannot be said. Once you say truth, it is untruth. Truth cannot be explained. Truth is unknown. Once you say it is truth, it is not true. So truth is absolute. Truth cannot be explained and told. The truth can be told in a different words. What we say? We say truth. Para Brahma we say. Then in Chinese, Tovo we say. So here, Gurdjieff, the philosopher, say law of three. In Christianity, three things are there. One is the father of father. Who is called father? It's God. That's what it say, father. Trinity, it is called Trinity. Trinity means what? In Christianity, entire Christianity, it is based on Trinity. Number one is God the Father. Second, Jesus the Son. God the Father, Jesus the Son. And third, what is the connection between God and the Son? It is the Holy Ghost. They say Holy Ghost. It is called Trinity. Trinity means what? See here, Gurdjieff says law of three. In Christians, they say Trinity. Trinity means what? God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Hinduism also, it is divided into three. What is it called? Trimurti. In Christianity, you say Trinity, T-R-I-N-I-T-Y. In Hinduism, you call Trimurti. Who are the Trimurti? That is the Absolute. Absolute means what? Total. It is Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva. Right, sir? So, in Christianity, it is Trinity. And in Hinduism, it is called Trimurti. But you take a science as a scientific person, scientists. What do the scientists say? Scientists also say the unknown is in three divisions. What are the three divisions? It is for scientists, electrons, protons, and neutrons. So, for Christianity, it's Trinity, Father, God, Son, Jesus Christ, then the Holy Ghost. For Hindus, it is Trimurti. It is Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva. And for scientists, it is electrons, protons, and neutrons. Okay, for poets, poets also divide this into three. What do they divide it into three? Satyam, Sivam, Sundaram. Satyam, Sivam, Sundaram. Satyam means what? Truth. Sivam means what? Good. Sundaram means what? Beauty. So, for the poet, Satyam, Sivam, Sundara. And for holy saints or what they say, spiritual persons, what do they say? They say, that is the mystics, they say what? Sat, Chit and Ananda. Mystics say Sat, Chit and Ananda. Sat means what? Sat, Chit and Ananda. Sat means existence. Existence means total. Chit means what? It is the consciousness. You understand what it is. Existence, Sat, Chit, the consciousness. Ananda, it is the bliss, the happiness, the joy, the pleasure, everything, whatever you get. So, what is this? Is absolute. Absolute is unknown. Anything which is known is relative. Absolute, if you say, even the absolute becomes a relative. So, the truth, truth is not truth. Even you say truth, it is untruth. So, Gurdjieff says law of three. Law of three in the sense for Hinduism, Christianity. Now, for scientists or poets or for any saints, all this divided into three parts. Right, sir? Now, coming here, what you see is the law of three behind the word Om. See, electrons, protons and neutrons, isn't it? Scientific science students are there. Protons and neutrons has a shape. You agree with that? But electrons doesn't have a shape. It cannot be seen. And the scientists, they say, there is nothing more than electrons. Electrons is the end. Just like what they say, the sounds, Om. After Om, there is no sound at all. It is the end. Like that. After electrons, nothing is there. All the matter is based on electrons. Because electrons, they can feel. They know. But they are unable to see electrons. So, electrons is the end. Science end. Nothing more than that. Every matter has protons, electrons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons can be seen. Electrons cannot be seen. So, after that, there is no power. Coming here, Christians and Mohammedans, they say Amen. Have you heard? After their prayer, they say Amen. Hindus, they say Om. See, all the gods in Hinduism, you find Om, the symbol is given. And Christians and Mohammedans, they say after their prayer, they say Amen. See the word, English words, omnipotent, omnipotent, om. Om means what in English as a prefix? Omni means very powerful, everywhere, omni, very powerful, omnipotent. Then omniscient, S-C-I-E-N-T, what do you mean by omniscient? Omnipotent means very strong, omnipresent means present everywhere, omniscient, can hear everywhere. So omni means so powerful, even that is divided into three. So om, this word you can find in all the languages, this om. See, coming here, absolute, what is absolute? Everybody having a question, isn't it? God is the end, they say. He is the creator. But once you say God, he is not absolute. He becomes a small person. Apart from that, who is there? Who created God? Okay, who created that God? If you say this God is a limited, this is a non-God, then who created that God? So, absolute. So, here the absolute can be told in negative and positive. Absolute means what? The total. It can be said in positive and negative. One Buddha, always he goes for negative terms. Nothingness, he says. Nirvana, he says. Nothingness, he says. Nirvana. Nirvana means what? Nothing is there. Suppose a drop of water go and mixes in ocean. What Buddha says? A drop of water, he says nothingness. It has become nothingness. A drop of water, if it goes to an ocean, he says what? The water, drop of water become a bigger water. It becomes an ocean. One drop is a big drop. That's all. A man, if he says, if he becomes a god, what Buddha will say? He has become a bigger man. But here, Upanishads, what do you mean by Upanishads? Upanishads, Hindu way of telling, they all go in for positive oriented of saying. Somebody is dead. Somebody is dead. Buddha way may say, is no more. Have you heard the word is no more? No more is a negative term. But in Upanishads or Hindu, they say he has become whole. He has become total. He has become divine. So Upanishads, even though it is a negative, even nothing is there, nothing is something for them. So in Hindu way of telling, even something, nothing is there, it has something. But Buddha always goes in for sunya, nirvana, nothingness. In nothingness, he finds unknown, absolute. So this absolute, total, either maybe it may be a positive or it may be a negative. So here, coming to the word om, you intone the word om louder. You say the word om louder because whenever you speak to others, only then you can hear, isn't it, sir? How do you hear your voice? When you speak to others, you can hear, is it so? Only when you speak in English, you come for English class, you come for Hindi class. When you speak to others, only then you can hear your voice. So, intone means, he says, here Shiva says, say the word Om loudly. As you say the word Om loudly, just be with the sound. Be with the sound. As you say the word Om, your body, it's a soft word or a hard word? Om. It's a soft word. See, any word which is soft, that enters your heart. Any word which is coarse or rough and tough, it won't enter in your heart. Have you heard it so? Any music, any song, it goes inside your heart because the, you know, the veins, the layers, the cells, which goes to your heart, is very small, narrow, only very, very narrow. But the very harsh sounds, it goes straight away to your head. It makes you awakened. But this makes you to give a soft feeling inside your body. Music, a soft music. So you listen, it goes inside your body. All your cells are getting vibrated. Your body is getting cleaned up. Slowly you feel like dancing. You become one with the sound. So as you say om, om, you know, the sound, you become one with the sound. All your body parts, tissues, cells, blood cells, white cells, what cells, nervous system, everywhere goes, because the sound is so soft. As the sound goes deeper and deeper, your body is a musical instrument. What do you mean by musical instrument? It can make sounds. So you feel like dancing. You feel exotic. You feel so expressive. A snake, when it hears the song, what happens? It starts dancing. Have you seen that? A snake, when it hears the sound, goes deep. It observes all the sounds and it starts dancing. So absorption, observing the sound, being with the sound, being one with the sound, it makes you to go deeper and deeper. Then once you are with the sound, slowly stop saying om. Say om inside your heart, inside, in tone, inside your body, inside your mouth. No, you're saying om. Whatever you're saying is not expressing outside. You cannot hear. So after first you are saying the word om outside, where you can hear. After being with the sound om, then you are going inside, deeper inside you. Slowly you are saying om, 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 om. And you are coming slowly, slowly, slowly down, deep down. But you should be very, very alert. When you keep on saying something, one thing continuously, what happens? You feel sleepy. You feel boredom. You feel what? Completely sleepy. That's why, you know, some people keep on writing the same word many times. You go to church, you go to temple, you watch a English movie which you have seen two or three times earlier. As you keep on watching the same movie, what happens? You know the story, but you feel sleepy. You hear the same class daily, what happens? You feel sleepy, boring, boredom happens. Whenever you see the same thing often, what happens? You become bored up. In village life, life is not excited. You go to a village, you see, first day you will feel happy, everything, because of, suppose you are going from Chennai, you are going to Ooty, being in a village, no sound, nothing is there, one day you will feel happy. You feel happy because of, not because of the hill station, because of what? Because of Chennai, because it's all sound, lot of sound, you are getting disturbed. So you go there, then after that you see the life, life is so boring. Good olden days people, there is no life excitement at all. No movie, no internet, no cell phone, no books, no colleges. Now only 550 engineering colleges were there, are there. Earlier, only 5. No job guarantee, you cannot go abroad. Here city life, here the life is so exciting, that's what people are unable to sleep. When you become so excited, what happens? Even when you go to sleep, you won't be able to sleep. But in good olden days, what happens? There is no excitement at all. Life is so boredom. It is a continuous routine. Same thing happening and happening. You feel so boredom and you feel so sleepy. As you say the word om, 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 you should be very alert that you are not going to sleep. You should be very alert. As you go deeper and deeper, then you come to the state of soundfulness or soundlessness. If it is Upanishad, they say soundfulness. If Buddha says, he says soundlessness, nirvana. You become one other Buddha. So you become continuously aware of everything. So you are living in the joy, in the pleasure, the happiness. So here, the problem here is, as you keep on saying the word, any word you say, you know, Greeks, they call hypnosis. What do you mean by hypnosis, sir? Hypnosis. You keep on, you ask somebody to slide down, and you tell him to close his eyes, and you keep on telling him something, slowly what happens? He is hypnotized. He starts believing everything. He creates a vision that everything is true. The hypnotic fellow will be saying, you are a rich man, you are a wealthy man, you are a brave man, you are a woman now, you are a man now, you are a girl now. He keeps on telling, so that this fellow in a hypnotic state, what happens? He will create a vision as if it is true. So suddenly when the hypnotized person says him, dance like so and so, like Prabhu Deva, like a Michael Jackson, he will start dancing even though he is not a dancer. Because in hypnotic state, when people keep on saying something, you will create a vision, and that vision will be 100% true for you. You won't agree that it is not true. You will agree with that. That is what the hypnotist techniques is all about. They keep on saying continuously same thing. So your mind becomes what? It will try to create a vision, and you are unable to come out of the vision. But when you are sleeping, you have a dream, you get a dream. When you are sleeping, you get a dream, right? After waking up, you know that it is a dream, right? But if you are hypnotized and you have vision, then after that, even somebody says this to you, that is not true, you won't agree, and you will say it is the truth. That is the difference between hypnotized person and a dream state. In dream state, you have the questioning mind. The mind will question in dream state. When you are sleeping, some terrible things happening in the dream, suddenly you wake up. Have you got up? Wake up. Because the questioning mind is there in your sleep. But in hypnotized state, your questioning mind is completely put on rest. You are unable to question at the time of when you are hypnotized. So it is hypnosis. So as you keep on saying that mantra, keep on saying, you should be alert. You should be very alert. But if you are not alert, what happens? You go to a state of hypnotized state and you will start sleeping. That is why whenever you have any problems, insomnia, you know what do you mean by insomnia? Not able to sleep. They tell you, go to church, go to temple, go somewhere, go listen some prayer songs. They'll put some songs. You keep on listening that songs. As you keep on listening, what happens? You feel sleepy. So this state, when you are doing that, telling the sound Om, keep on saying the sound Om inwardly, slow by slow you are reducing the sound, slowly. As you reduce the sound, the alertness should increase more and more. Because as you decrease the sound, what happens? You feel sleepy. But as you reduce the sound, you have to be more alert. Alertness should be there. More alertness should be there. Next, coming here, if a person is hypnotized, you see, have you seen some people say, Krishna came and told me to build a temple, so I am building a temple. He says, the God has come and told. He won't say it is a dream. He won't say it is a dream. He will say, truly God, Krishna has come, Lord Muruga has come, Christ has come in my dream, and he told like this. That's why you see preachers, they say, he may be a handicapped person, right? He will say, you are able to walk, you are able to walk, you are able to walk. They keep on saying, then finally that fellow starts walking. Have you seen that in big Christian preaching? He may be blind fellow, you can see, you can see, you can see. That's what they keep on saying. As they keep on saying, as you hear, you fall a prey for the words, then what happens? The vision which is created through the hypnotized talk, continuous talk, you will have that vision and you won't believe that is untrue. Your questioning ability you will lose. So you should be alert at the time of. So when a Christian is hypnotized, or keep on saying, he will say Jesus Christ. When a Hindu is hypnotized, and if he keeps on saying Krishna, he says Krishna has come in flute, playing with the flute, came with the flute and dancing with gopis. This God has come, that God. A businessman, he keeps on saying something, he will be always dreaming in money. So every technician, so everybody, you keep on saying something, you become like that. But you should be alert that is not true. As you keep on saying, you should go deeper and deeper with more alertness. You should go to a state where there is nothing is there. Because the word Om, after that there is nothing else is there. That nothingness or everything is there, the absolute. The absolute is the real power. The absolute is you have known everything. So simple. You want to know everything, then you have to go deeper and deeper. Om is the last word. Electron is the last word for scientists. Ghost is the last word for Christians. And Shiva is the last word for what? Hindus. So beyond that, nothing is there. When you go Om deeper and deeper, Om is the last word. Beyond Om, you have known the absolute. Unknown. Known is Om. Unknown is something absolute. So that is what you are coming here. So as you keep on saying, you know, mother, a mother is sleeping. A child, she may be in whatever dream she is. A child, if she or he cries, the baby cries, immediately she wakes up, isn't it? So even in her sleeping, her questioning mind is there. She will take care of the child. But hypnotized person, when you are intoning the voice, slowly going deeper and deeper, going inside, unless you are not alert, unless you are alert, you are going to lose into vision. Then it becomes one other mantra. That's what Mahesh Yogi's transcendental meditation, many meditations are there. It is all telling the same things. Temples, they say the same things. In churches, they say the same things. As you keep on hearing the same things, you feel very comfortable. In the sense, it is like a lullaby. You can sleep, but you cannot know the unknown. I hope you are able to understand. Hope you are able to understand. Yes. Now please take the mic. Where's the mic? Now, I request each one of you to tell what you are able to understand. Absolute, the unknown. The relative is known. Whatever you know, it is not unknown. It is not absolute. So, absolute is something which cannot be stated. And everything is divided into three. For Christians or Hindus or Mohammedans or fire scientists, artists, or for any people, it's divided into three. The sound Om, if you want to know the sound, what is behind Om sound? Om is the end word. After that, nothing is there. So to go in for nothingness, you have to keep on saying the Om. Om is a very powerful word. All religions has accepted Om is the most powerful word. As you keep on saying outside and going inside and saying the Om, keep on saying that, you should not get bored up by saying the same word. Otherwise, you go in for sleeping. So what you have to be, as you say it slowly, slowly, involving deeper and deeper with the word, your mind should be alert. And as you become alert, the sound slowly goes off. And there you find the absolute. There you find the unknown. So what you are able to understand? Please get up. The other mic is also not there. Okay.
Okay. Check. Osho Shiv Sutra 39 says, intone a sound, Om. Say the sound Om slowly in you. As it enters soundlessness. Om, AUM. Has three sounds. There was a saint, Gurdjieff. He said law of three. Seer, seen and relationship. Seer is the one who sees. Seen is the object, what he sees. And the in-between thing is the knowledge. Lao Tzu was another scientist, was another saint. Short, okay. As you intone the saying Om in you, it enters deep inside you. As it enters deep inside you, you will feel alert. You should feel alert. This will result in absoluteness. Absoluteness is the power. This is what Shiv Sutra 39 says.
Also Siva Sutra 39, into a sound as a om is slowly, om is three types, om are three sounds, this is the law of three absolute rules plus relative absolute cannot see in, and this seer, seen, and relations. The law to the truth is cannot be said, the knowledge and sight, and the truth, true is always truth, and the Buddha and moment.